Hi guys, I'm Stuti and this is Merawala Grief, a podcast for anyone dealing with loss. If you're someone who's going through this, I just want to tell you, there's no need to rush because har episode mein, every time we've discussed this with anyone, ek cheez jo hum samajh gaye hain, wo hai ki chahe is pain aapki zindagi mein aaye hue kuch mahine, kuch hafte hue ho ya bade saal beet gaye ho, but it stays. It's just that we learn slowly to carry it and negotiate with it. The guest on my show today is someone very, very special, Vikas Khanna. Honestly, in his case, this name is enough. He's a celebrity chef. He wears many hats, a film director, writer. He owns restaurants. People know him. And he's joining us from New York. Thank you so much, Vikas.
Thank you, Sati.
You are in the business of swad, है ना? Food एक ऐसी चीज है इंसान memory से बहुत connect करता है. And जब अपना कोई चला जाता है तो लगता है जिंदगी से स्वाद थोड़ा कम हो गया है. आपने उस phase में क्या किया? How did you deal with it?
So you know, we just a few days back we lost a very dear friend, JP. And you have to remember that, you know, if we are only mourning or hum agar sirf ro rahe hain, agar sirf afsos kar rahe hain, and that person didn't want to be remembered like that. And that is where, you know, I felt that, you know, even in my case, with all the relatives I've lost or friends I've lost during this time, we said you have to remember them with amazing love and what they stood for and who they were. But they didn't want us to be so sad, because you remember when my grandmother passed away, my aunt said ke BG ki kabhi wish nahi thi unki puri family baith ke kamre mein sirf roye. That was not she wanted a family to be like. So, you know, I thought that was something which was very healing for me, to say that you're right, you know, there's a way to remember these people, and that is with so much of tremendous love, abundance, what they gave us. उसी टाइम पे भी नॉट टू फॉरगेट दैट, यू नो, दैट देयर इज नो वे, देयर इज नो प्राइस टैग ऑन दिस, दैट हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल एबल टू सी देम अगेन. और आई नो रिसेंटली देयर इज एन ऐप इन व्हिच यू कैन मेक अ पर्सन ब्लिंक,
या
एंड यू नो इट्स लाइक वी टेक इट सो मच फॉर ग्रांटेड. एंड आई डिड दैट ऐप फॉर माय मॉम्स फादर, शी वाज वेरी क्लोज टू हिम. और मम्मा कह रहे हैं दुनिया में जितने पैसे हैं सब कुछ दे लो, आई जस्ट वांट टू सी हिम ब्लिंक वन टाइम. आई सेड मॉम, ही इज ब्लिंकिंग इन यू, ही इज ब्लिंकिंग इन मी, ही इज ब्लिंकिंग इन आवर सिब्लिंग्स, आवर फैमिली, आवर नीसेस. दे आर नॉट गॉन, दे आर जस्ट चेंजिंग द फॉर्म. पर कहना आसान है ज्योति एट दिस टाइम, बिकॉज यू नो वी हैव सीन लॉस ऑफ लाइफ एट अ मैग्नीट्यूड व्हिच वी डिडंट इवन इमेजिन एज ह्यूमंस, एंड वी वर नॉट इवन प्रिपेयर्ड एज पीपल. You know, you were not even prepared ki itna loss around you, and it has been a dark era in many ways.
I think you have I would see your tweets, you've done so much is Doran, even otherwise. I mean, you're a philanthropist, you're a humanist. Somewhere it also, you know, I always feel ki kahin pe insaan jo pain khud mehsoos karta hai later in life, they want ki logon ki life se agar thoda kam kar paaye तो एक अलग तरीके का सुकून मिलता है. आई सी दैट इन द वे यू गो अबाउट योर वर्क, व्हिच यू नो, चाहे द फर्स्ट फेज ऑफ लॉकडाउन था या उसके बाद, यू ऑलवेज ट्राइड टू डू इट. एक इंटरव्यू में यू स्पोक अबाउट गिल्ट. आई थॉट दैट वाज वेरी ऑनेस्ट, बिकॉज कई चीजें रह जाती हैं, हम नहीं कह पाते हैं. हैव यू मैनेज्ड टू मेक पीस विद दैट विकास, विद गिल्ट?
No, I when people say, "Oh my God, you are such an exemplary son," I said, "I'm not. You know, I left everything and I made a life of my own, and I left them. Not that I left them, you know, physically, but I was always for them. So, वो guilt हर NRI के पास है, हर immigrant के पास वो रहेगी, as long as the conscience is very much alive and it's it breathes, the conscience breathes. I was reading this new thing that if your conscience is breathing, you, there's no way as a human you will not feel guilt. Sometimes I'm even guilty when you achieve a landmark or something which is, I know people find that very strange when I say sometimes there's a big milestone in my life. And you know, my whole career is based on the first. Like there's so many firsts in my life. Like first to do this, first to be on this, first in that chef's world in America. And you know, of course, author's world and filmmaker's world also. We've had, uske saath guilt aati hai. You know, you feel somehow, you know. Pata nahi kyun, you know, I paid a big price for that. And alternatively, people keep asking me that what your life would have been if you were still selling bhaturas in Amritsar. I'm like, no, I don't know. Maybe I would have had less guilt. But then I also had to answer my own self.
Yeah.
You know, there were dreams. There were compelling passions of me to perform on the world stage. Tab phir ek guilt to aati, tab phir ek regret hota. So I chose between not to have a regret of how am I going to experiment with my life. तो स्तुति कभी कभी मुझे लगता है उससे मेरा बैलेंस हो रहा है मेरे को लगता है मैं एक्चुअली दिल के खुश रखने को गालिब ख्याल अच्छा है तो दैट इज हाउ आई समटाइम्स कंसोल माय सेल्फ दैट यू नो ऑफ कोर्स आई डिड रॉन्ग थिंग बट आई आल्सो आई रिमेम्बर व्हेन आई वाज लिविंग इंडिया माय लास्ट कम्युनिकेशन विद माय ग्रैंड मॉम वाज आई टॉक्ड अबाउट मिशलिन स्टार शी हैड नो आइडिया व्हाट आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट Because, you know, in the college, the professor had once told me that you don't have to worry about the stars. These are not for Indians. So, that was the thing in my mind somehow. And when I left, I said, BG, I'll go to know, but I'll show the winner. And she didn't even remember. She didn't connect to it. What will she show the winner? I mean, from here, the fight is running from Amritsar. So, what will she show the winner? You know, you're breaking all of us. And sometimes guilt is okay. You know, guilt also keeps you very alert. That you have to do walk in one extra mile.
Yeah, yeah. No, aapne jo baat boli that it's, you know, har NRI kid mein hota. I think anyone, because there comes a phase in our lives when we feel like we have to build our lives. Padhai ho, ya naukri ho, ya koi personal life ho, insaan usme itna hum kho jaate hain that we forget that our near ones, parents or siblings or someone else in our life needs us. I was speaking to Guneet. And, you know, she obviously is, and I'll come to that about how faith played a role in her journey towards healing.
Of course.
But she says ki abhi bhi na tyoharon mein ya jab success milti hai, koi award milta hai, to she says abhi bhi thoda phika lagta hai because those eyes are not there to look at me. Do you feel their presence, Vikas, ya ye aapke? You also feel this?
See, I became a continuity of all the ancestors, right? In a way that cooking is actually in continuity. You know, it's like jo purkhon ne banaya tha, jo phir unke baad hamare grandparents ne, parents ne, families, extended families ne jo. So for me, somehow I have consoled or I have kind of come to terms. I don't know if this is the right word, but I have to come to terms that whatever I'm doing, whatever I'm putting on the plate is also a representation of them.
Yeah.
Of course, it's very difficult because, you know, I work in the Western world and some days your food is not accepted and people say, are ye kya cooking hui, you know? I remember first time I served buddies from Amritsar. So we were making buddies in a dehydrator and, you know, it cannot taste like jo India ki hoti hai. And somebody said, "Arey yaar, ye kaisa hai? You are destroying our food." And I still remember it. That hurt me very much. I'm like, "Oh my God, this food doesn't belong to me. I'm actually a caretaker or a guardian." So I understand where Guneet is coming from. And yes, I feel that sometimes success looks very empty to me. Though I'm one of the privileged ones who lives in many countries, but I still feel that the success is very some days. I feel it's very empty. And but, you know, I also have a great honor that my mom is very connected to me morning, night.
Yeah.
And even when I just came back from running, like, you know, before I went for running, I had to speak to her because that's my first voice I want to hear, Abibi. It's going to be always there. And, you know, it's good. It also tells you that this pain is something which makes you feel that you're alive.
Yeah.
You're not comfortably numb at one point. You don't even feel all this. Especially for artists, you know, the pain gets exaggerated and you see in form of my writing, in form of everything. And even if you see the last color is the form of pain.
Yeah.
What I felt for the women in my neighborhood, in my families, in how, in my people, like the people I knew went through this, you know, they were totally isolated and without any color. So, kabhi kabhi pain helps you to form a different world. You create a new world to get some relief to you. You know, mujhe laga ke us time pe bachpan mein mujhe pata nahi tha ki questions valid hai ki nahi hai. So sometimes you feel that closure comes from when you create something which directly supports the pain. And you saw that, you know, I took that a small issue of why no color and I made it so symbolic. And that was actually from real life experiences. There was no fiction in it in that point. Of course, the characters were fictionalized. Yeah. Everything was, you know, it's a cinema. I also understood that I need to entertain or I need to involve people.
Yeah.
But mujhe lagta hai ki kabhi kabhi closure ke liye it is good. And you know, just recently Mr. Poddar, Sushil Poddar, Nidhi Poddar, they wrote a book on the closure of their son's life in a way. It's called Blaze. I think aaj uska release hai. And I read the book and it just crushed me. It's about losing a very young son and how they used his life as a legacy. It's like, and to tell the people that loss is not something that it is the end. It is actually a new form being created.
That's very beautifully put. Vikas, I want you to speak about that. I thought that's such an enduring story, or a lot of people will be able to relate to it. Jo aapne bola about how you bought a car for your father, and he said, "Mera hamesha man tha," but he never said. He never, you know, and that's how parents are, that's how fathers are, that they never say it in as many words, ki wo kya karna chahte hain, kya nahin. And after he went away, you kind of, that's when you decided that you want to spend more time with your mother and you were more conscious about the fact that you should be around them.
So I'm just saying that, you know, when Papa said that, you know, it's a big day and everything. And then he said, I just saw your contract for the partnership with Mercedes and it was my dream to get a car like that. And I'm like, Papa bol dete mere ko Mercedes 10 gadi khadi kar dunga, you know, the typical Punjabi way of exaggerating a comment. He kehnde nahi tu kadi maine puchha hi nahi. And he passed away after 1.5 hours something. It hit me so badly and he just said it jokingly. So baat mujhe laga ki, oh my god, hum poochte nahi hai parents ko, and they somehow, when the kids are born, they begin to fade out their own wishes, their own dreams, because their focus is just raising that kid. And you know how that could be, kid could have, bring some value or maybe support. And in my case, a total useless child who could be supported for his dream to be a chef. And I know how they sacrificed everything. And wo pain bahut rahi. And you know, after he passed away, I went back to Amritsar next day. Early morning, I landed and I called the people from Mercedes. I said, I need the car right now in the house. And mama, like everybody's like, typical, are, why at this point? I said, nahi, galti hogi, ab wait nahi karni dobara se kabhi, kabhi wait nahi karni. And it's funny, every time I talk to mom, you're talking about Papa and say, Mama, you have to tell me what you want to do. And she'll say, you know how they are so simple. And she's like, simple si koi wish hoti hai. So I kata, lo, Mama, maangne to ab, Mount Everest maang lo. But it is like, nahi, ye mujhe chahiye tha. I'm like, okay, Mama, aapke paas pahuncha hoga thodi der mein. So I think it also made me alert of the value of time, you know, because you can, everything in businesses, what we bear, is a loss, and people cry too much about it. And even in my own partners and my own team, they're like, oh chef, what a loss for you, what is this, it's terrible. I'm like, really? No, not really. I've experienced a loss which is irreplaceable. Businesses will come and businesses will go. You know, we have a model where we think about way too much about more meaningful work than just business work. Because sometimes I fail very badly, and that's okay. because I still want to create original work, right? I have not cloned my career based on other people. Mm-hmm. I have not totally focused on. So I also take a lot of risks. You know, at 50 years old, I'm going to be in a few months, and I'm totally focused on even taking bigger risks about my career and art and how I represent myself in the Western world and the world. So mujhe lagta hai ke kabhi-kabhi you have to value that the loss of businesses and your career and sometimes ups and downs, that is not at all permanent. That loss of my dad was the only permanent loss at that time, untimely, which struck me like lightning. And it is irreplaceable. Koi baat aage na, just to see him blink, I'm ready to give away everything. You know, at this time, there's no way. You know, that's the cycle of nature. And then we bring the gods and say that, you know, Bhagwan ki ye marzi thi, itna hi time tha. And that time you realize ki your biggest loss is that you couldn't spend the time. So for someone to ask me, are you still guilty? I am. I will always be guilty. And that is good. Because, you know, then you also need to find way to comfort yourself. So, Papa ne mera pehla tandoor mujhe leke diya tha. And which was totally against the norm. I don't know many dads in India who will buy their beta tandoor. And be so proud in the family ke tandoor. Dekho, mera beta tandoor lagata hai. And I was a kid and I did it. I still do tandoor very fast. More than most of the trained chefs. But then I said, you know, let's open a museum in his name. Let's keep the legacy going that if that day that tandoor was which motivated me, small thing, 100 rupees ki cheez bhi nahi hogi. Tab ki baat karo, main 19, like, you know, 80s ki. And I realized ke, then you have to find ways to give a tribute to the lives I lived for you and with you. And though it was shorter and it was cut short by the God's will, there were still moments which will uplift you forever.
You know, you made such an important point ki actual loss kya hai, jab wo experience kar lo na, to insan samajh jata hai priority kya hai.
Log keh raha ye nahi hua to ye nahi bik raha to wo nahi, main kaha yaar wo to theek hai, wo kabhi bikega, kabhi out of stock wali cheeze hamari kabhi bilkul nahi hilti, you know, which is normal because I also don't do templated books. So sometimes kya hota hai ki most of the chef's career, you know, we see this hit me a good mark. This worked for me, home style cooking. And now for the rest of my life, I'm going to do just the home style cooking. And that is what every artist does. They found the equation of success and they stick to it. Mereko, because my real, the counseling which really helped me was from His Holiness Dalai Lama. And he said that, I know you're mourning right now. This is when I was writing the book, Timeless Legacy with him. He's saying, I know you're mourning the loss right now, but you have to remember that it's just changing of forms. Energy was form change kar liye bas. And you need to find for that energy and you need to find what resonates that wavelength and you need to connect to that. And I think wo loss ke baad wo cheeze na aapko bahut conscious ho rahte ho aapke. And sometimes I'll see somebody, you know, I'll tell you a small incident. Day before yesterday, I can't tell you that which city we are opening a restaurant. But I was just in the interview and I asked this girl, who's the hiring girl, and she said that, you know, chef, there's a chef on next chef on interview. His name is Dev. Papa ka naam Devinder tha. I couldn't unhear the name as I'm talking to him. I kept hearing Devinder. And it was, and you know, it's interesting that they are alive in everything. But some days to find the closure to that, you need to do something for them because they are watching you. Do something, you know, if your pain is too deep and you feel that, feed people, do something because that is what they wanted you to be. That is why they sacrificed their whole life to create those values in you. And do that. And it will make you good. Even if it's for a short period of time, it will make you good. Make you feel good. I feel that.
Abhi, because... Do you feel his presence? Yaad aati hai? Do you have bad days? Abhi bhi, does it hit you? Jaise abhi Dev ke case mein hua.
So my dad used to manage my business also. So mom does it amazingly now. But after he left, you know, I felt that I was without the umbrella. There was no shade for me. I was right in front of so many predators. And sometimes as an artist, you don't understand those terms. जो लिखा होता है ना स्मॉल फॉन्ट में, अब वो नहीं पढ़ा होता आपने. उनके जाने के बाद तो इट्स लाइक होली आई एम लाइक हु आर दिस पीपल लिटरली एंड not as a protector but he was there as a very important guide and a moral compass but that's what parents are that is why we are talking about them that why it matters so much why when you open the last color the first visual is dedicated to my beloved father Shuddhavinda Khanna because I have to keep him alive in some way or the other and right now in the conversation also It's not making me sad. I'm talking about him that he's not there anymore. I feel that he lived with me and for me, and that is amazing. That I had this opportunity to have amazing grandparents and amazing father. I don't care about how successful he was. Of course, mujhe daan bahut padti thi. I was his delivery boy in the video cassette library, and I was terrible because I have numbers ka issue. I've got dyslexia type. Okay. Keep getting confused and I had a lot of issues but he was forgiving he used to say ke artist ko zarurat nahi hoti numbers yaad karne ki hum jo hain and when he left so I felt ke oh my god I have to literally learn how to do this whole thing from scratch and it was a very tough few years and to find balance I went to Varanasi and because Haridwar Varanasi were his favorite places in Vaishno Devi And that is where I wrote the last color. I wrote it for him. And thank God, I would have never gone to Varanasi that day if it was not for him. That I was searching for him. कि मुझे कोई closure चाहिए, मुझे कोई बता दे. And my boat guy, you know, if, I don't know if you saw Feed India, that we were speeding entire busties of boat walas.
Yeah.
Because that boat guy told me कि what are you looking at? The reflection in Ganga ji. And you know, this one time when you were in Varanasi. That you can see your sun ki positioning and sari. Sabhi to sar jhukate hain wahan pe, suraj bhi. And you see your reflection so clearly. Kehte, arre, wohi to papa ji hain. Oh my, I wanted somebody to tell me that. Arre, papa ji ko dhoond rahe, papa ji wohi to hain. Wohi to parchhai mein, har parchhai mein to wohi hain. Maine nahi, mujhe, I knew it, but I wanted somebody else to tell me this, that he's there. What are you saying he's gone? And we were near Manikarnika Ghat and I saw those people there and said, oh my God, what a cycle of life. And that helped me, Suti. I'll be honest with you. That little comment helped me. Ke, Are, unko to dekh rahe ho. And then I saw one of the Amitabh Bachchan's ad in which he says, ke, Har tasmeer mein wahi to muskurate hain.
Yeah.
Unki aankhon mein wahi to chalkate hain. And I felt, ke, oh my God, that's a good way to understand that you know they are still with you and you have to still continue to get up out of the bed and even after the world trying to bury you and burn you down you still have to fight it because you come from their extension and I feel that
you have to make that pain your strength
you have to take your broken heart and turn it into greater art something like that
You know, finally, Vikas, जो इस वक्त ये कॉन्वर्सेशन देख रहे हैं सुन रहे हैं एंड दे वुड बी वंडरिंग आई वॉन्ट टू रीच दिस स्टेज दैट विकास इज इन ही इज सच होल्ड ऑन हिज इमोशंस आई कांट गेट आउट ऑफ बेड और आई कांट स्टॉप क्राइंग और आई जस्ट कांट लिव विदाउट हिम व्हाट विल यू टेल देम
आई टेल देम व्हाट हैपेंड टू मी इन वाराणसी यू नो घर में यू नो व्हाट हैपेंस बिकॉज़ ही वाज इट वाज वेरी अनएक्सपेक्टेड लॉस And a lot of relatives, everybody started traveling to Amritsar and you know, last condolences, you know, last memory, last love. And it was very hard for me. And because anyone will start talking about him and I will, it was very difficult for me. And I told mom, I'm going to Varanasi. And she said, go. She knew it. Like, you know, I'm going to be safe in that city. Main yehi bolna chahunga, ki, you know, Just remember that they have left a much bigger legacy than you can imagine. That's you. That's you. Even if it's your child, sibling, parents, grandparents, you are an extension of them. And they don't want to see an extension of them lost, feeling defeated, feeling that this is the end of the road. You need to get up. You need to find a new path. To get distracted and do something for them in their name. And if you look at some of the greatest literature and arts that was written after a huge loss, a huge loss. And my next movie is after my grandmom passed away. I wrote the novel, a short story then, and I made it into a movie. Mm. After my dad, I wrote Last Color and the museum and these conversations and understanding that there is still light because they left in you a lot of light.
Yeah. That's a beautiful thing to end this conversation with. Thank you so much, Vikas, for being so honest.
Take care.
Thank you.
Take care. Always good. Bye. Fever.